All right, everybody, today we are going to be taking a look at the ideal gas law, and we are going to be looking at how we can relate the laws that we've talked about before to the ideal gas law. We'll talk about conditions when it applies and when it holds true, and then obviously exceptions to that condition as well. So the ideal gas law is essentially a combination of all the laws that we have looked at. We typically write the equation as PV equals NRT. The P stands for pressure, V for volume, N for moles, R is the constant, which is 0.0821 liters times atmospheres per mole Kelvin, and then T is temperature in Kelvin. If we look at the kind of laws that we saw before, basically, to get the ideal gas law, if we think of, like for Boyle's law, that volume is proportional to 1 over P, if we kind of replace the proportionalities with the R as a constant, then we can derive the ideal gas law. But if we look at the ideal gas law and then we say, okay, well, pressure and volume, but N, R, and T are all constant, then we get the gas law P times V equals P2 times V2. Or same thing is true for volume and temperature. So volume is directly related to temperature. If all of the other variables are constant, then we get Charles' law. And so with these, we can kind of see how that works. Now, the ideal gas law is going to apply and hold true whenever we have low pressure and high temperature, because then the molecules can be spread apart. In real life, even though they might not follow this exactly, most of the time the numbers are good enough and can be used to calculate different things. Now, the non-ideal gas conditions then would be low temperature and high pressure. The reason why these aren't ideal is because they're breaking that kinetic molecular theory of gases that said that gases are very far spread apart, that they don't have any interactions with one another, that they have elastic collisions. And whenever they're at low temperature and high pressure, what happens is that the molecules are much closer together. There's going to be more intermolecular forces or intermolecular interactions, and so then those ideal gas law conditions won't necessarily apply. Let's do a few practice problems. So calculate the volume occupied by 0.845 moles of nitrogen gas at a pressure of 1.37 atmospheres and a temperature of 315 Kelvin. So whenever we look at this, we're going to use our equation and we'll write down our givens. And so we're given everything except for volume. And so volume will be equal to moles times the constant times temperature divided by pressure. So we'd have 0.845 moles. Our constant is going to be 0.0821 liter atmosphere mole Kelvin. Our temperature 315 Kelvin. And then our pressure 1.37 atmospheres. So Kelvin will cancel out, moles will cancel out, atmospheres will cancel out, we'll be left with liters. And so our volume for this is going to be 16 liters. All right, so let's go ahead and do another example. This one is going to allow us to calculate the molar mass by using the ideal gas law. So first we'll calculate the moles and then we will calculate the molar mass. So a sample of gas has a mass of 0.136 grams. The volume is 0.112 liters at a temperature of 298 Kelvin and a pressure of 1.06 atmospheres. Find the molar mass. So we'll do our same equation. PV equals NRT. This time we'll solve for N. And so N is going to be equal to PV over RT. So we'll plug in our numbers. You can go ahead and do this on your own if you want and solve. All right, so we're left with our moles. So our moles are going to be so N is 4.8 8.25 times 10 to the negative third moles. We're going to put our mass over our moles to get our molar mass. And so whenever we do this, our molar mass is going to be 28 grams per mole. All right, so you'll do some practice problems. Let me know if you have any questions.